carbon and its compounds. In this particular video, we'll be studying about a quick revision of alkane, alkenes and alkynes. Let's talk about the IPSC namings also. IPSC names of hydrocarbon consist of two parts: word root, number of carbon in the longest carbon chain, and for that you need to remember that if a molecule of hydrocarbon is having carbon, one carbon in it, root word will be meth. If a molecule has two carbon numbers in it, the name is eth. 3, prope. 4, bute. 5, pent. 6, hex. 7, hept. 8, oct. 9, non. 10, dec. So you need to remember this, कि हाइड्रोकार्बन का नाम शुरुआत होगी, दैट विल बी डिसाइडेड बाय द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम्स प्रेजेंट इन इट, एंड यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस टेबल सो दैट यू कैन इजीली नेम इट. द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द हाइड्रोकार्बन इज डिसाइडेड बाय द नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन प्रेजेंट इन इट. सुफिक्स, एज आई वाज टेलिंग यू दैट स्टार्टिंग पार्ट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एंड द रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन. सो हाउ डू वी कम टू नो हाउ मेनी हाइड्रोजन्स आर देयर? वी कम टू नो that what is the suffix used in that. If the name is being given, if the molecular formula is given, then you need to see which general formula it is following. If a hydrocarbon has a single bond, then the suffix is ane. If double bond, ene. If triple bond, yne. The first homologous series is alkane. As the name indicates, in the spelling, it has ane in the last, and this is the suffix used in the entire homologous series. So first member of alkanes is methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, decane. As we have already studied also, the general formula followed by alkane is CnH2n plus 2. Next homologous series, alkene. The general formula followed is CnH2n. First member of this homologous series is C2H4, which is ethene. Why the word eth? Because carbon are two here. So that is the root word, and as it belongs to alkene homologous series, so suffix is ene. Second member, propene. So here even in the structure you can say that it has double bond, but as we move to the third member, that is butene, even it is being mentioned that where the double bond is. So it is between 2 and 3 carbon number. So we try to give the lowest number to the double bond. So we'll be counting it like this. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it has 4 carbons in it. So we'll say that it is attached between carbon number 2 and 3. So the number given will be 2. So that bute 2-ene gives you a hint that it is present between carbon number 2 and 3. Bute 1-ene means that the double bond is between carbon number 1 and 2. 1-pentene, because the bond is between carbon number 1 and 2. So you can write it as 1-pentene, you can even write it as pent 1-ene. So both the ways are okay. 2-pentene, you can see that the double bond is between carbon number 2 and 3. 1-hexene, 2-hexene and 3-hexene. So all these are hexene, why they have given it three times, or pentene is being given two times, so that you can understand that if double bond is being shifted, means over here it was between 1 and 2, over here it was in between 2 and 3. You may be thinking it can be between 3 and 4. No, it cannot be between 3 and 4. Reason, because when it will be between these two carbons, so we are going to count from this side. Because we have a freedom of counting from both the sides, and we need to give the lowest number to the position of the carbon which is having the double or a triple bond. So if it will be between these two carbon atoms, so we'll be counting it from this side, will be 1, 2, and then again it will be between. So it makes the same thing, so that's why it's not being shown here. But in hexene, that's why they have been shown that if it is between carbon number 1 and 2, so we'll be writing it 1 hexene. If it is between 2 and 3, we'll be writing as 2 hexene. If it is between 3 and 4, we'll be writing 3 hexene. But there will be no 4 hexene, because if it is between this and this carbon, so we'll be counting from the left hand side. Next homologous series, alkyne. General formula followed is CnH2n-2. The first member is ethyne, as it has carbon number 2 and there is triple bond between carbon and carbon atom. So that's why the suffix used is yne. Molecular formula C2H2. Propyne, there is a triple bond between carbon number 2 and 3. Or we are going to say it's between 1 or 2. So we'll be not counting from this side, rather we'll be counting from that side. So we'll be telling that it is between 1 and 2. Instead of telling that it is between 2 and 3, we will prefer to give it name as 1-propene. We are not going to give it as 2-propene. Hum isko bolenge 1-propene. So as earlier also I have told, ki hum counting karke 1, 2, 3 aise nahi karenge. Hum isko 1 bolenge aur isko 2 बोलेंगे, so that की जो ट्रिपल बॉन्ड है उसको कम से कम नंबरिंग मिले, एंड विल बी कॉलिटिंग एज 1-propyl. सो सिमिलरली विल बी काउंटिंग फ्रॉम दिस साइड फॉर दिस 1, 2, 3, 4, सो विल बी टेलिंग इट एज 1-butyn. सिमिलरली 1-pentyn. So you need to be very careful regarding the counting and giving the position where the triple bond is present, and you need to remember the molecular formula, structural formula and the names. Steps to write IPSC nomenclature of hydrocarbons. Select the parent carbon chain. So you need to first select the longest chain. Select the longest carbon chain as the parent chain. If a double bond or a triple bond is present in the carbon chain, it should be included in the parent chain. Number of parent carbon chain from that carbon end, such that the double bond or the triple bond or the side chain get the lowest number. तो अगर कोई double bond या triple bond है, तो आपने इस तरीके से count करना है कि उसको lowest number मिले. और अगर parent chain से कोई side chain attached है, तो भी आपने उसको इस तरीके से काउंट करना है दैट इट गेट्स द लोएस्ट नंबर. आइडेंटिफाई एंड नेम द साइड चेन इफ एनी, लाइक इफ इट इज CH3 इज नेम्ड एज मिथाइल, इफ C2H5 देन इट इज नेम्ड एज इथाइल. ऑल्सो आइडेंटिफाई द पोजिशन ऑफ द साइड चेन कि मिथाइल या इथाइल अटैच्ड कहाँ पर है, आपने वो भी काउंटिंग करनी है. Then write the name of the hydrocarbon first. This is the first step. So they are taking an example. Position number of the side chain, or like let's take this example. So in this case, what is the parent chain, which is the longest chain? You can count it vertically as well as horizontally. So horizontally, if we count, there are 4 carbon. If we count vertically, there are only 2 carbon. So this will be the parent chain. So as it has 4 carbons in it, so it will be called as butte. As a parent chain is having a double bond, so it will be butene. Now where is the double bond? That also we need to mention. So date is between carbon number 1 and 2, so that's why but-1-ene. So that's giving you the information where is the double bond. So double bond is between carbon number 1 and 2. So this is the parent chain. Now is there any side branching to it? Yes. So there's a side branching. What is the name of this side branching? Because when we took the name of the parent chain, we have counted only these four carbon. So we need to mention it separately. So this is methyl. So it is attached to carbon number 2. So we'll be writing as 2-methyl-but-1-ene. Okay? Remember, if the hydrocarbon is an alkane, the position number of the suffix is not written. ठीक है, फिर क्योंकि अगर ये है, क्योंकि यहाँ पर तो डबल बॉन्ड था ना, इसलिए हमें डबल बॉन्ड बताने की वजह से हमें ऐसे लिखना पड़ा but-1-ene. अगर ये सेचुरेटेड होता तो हमें ऐसा कुछ नहीं करना पड़ता, फिर हम सीधा ही इसको ब्यूटेन लिख देते. तो ये सेवेंथ पॉइंट में ये बताना चाहते हैं कि सेचुरेटेड के लिए हमें ऐसी कोई पोजिशन बताने की जरूरत नहीं होती. ये चीज हमें डबल या ट्रिपल बॉन्ड्स के लिए बताने की जरूरत थी. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट होमोलोगस सीरीज, द फर्स्ट होमोलोगस सीरीज ऑफ एल्केन, डू वी फाइंड एनी डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन द होमोलोगस मेंबर्स ऑफ द होमोलोगस सीरीज? सो लेट्स स्टडी दैट. मीथेन, इथेन, प्रोपेन, ब्यूटेन एंड पेंटेन एंड मेंशनड इन दिस ग्रुप. So these are the molecular formula. Do you find any difference between them? Yes. In the molecular formula, you will always find a difference of CH2. There is always an increase of 1 carbon and 2 hydrogen. So could you see? 1 carbon over 2, 3, 4, 5. There is an increase of 1. But when we look at hydrogen, there is only an increase of 2 hydrogen atoms successively. They agree every step. So we can see 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. There is only an increase of 2 hydrogen. So these are the structures. Number of carbons are being given. Now let's have a look on the physical properties. Boiling point. Could you see that what is the trend as you move, as the number of atoms in the molecule is increasing, or you can say as the molecular mass is increasing, because there is an increase of molecular mass with every increase in CH2, means there will be increase of 14 there will be increase in molecular mass also, because 1 carbon and 2 hydrogen is being added successively. So there is a increase in the boiling point. Could you see that there is an increase in the boiling point? Similarly, you can have a look of melting point also. There is increase in the melting point also, because as the number of atoms in the molecule is increasing, so more and more energy is required to break those molecule bonds between those atoms. So that's why boiling and melting point is increasing. Density, if you look at the density is also increasing. So this is the pattern in the homologous series. So it's observed in all the homologous series. Now name of alkane, number of carbons present in it, molecular formula, and name of the alkyl group. So this table I have taken it so that sometimes you get confused between alkyl. So methane, what is methane? CH4. If one of the hydrogen is not present in methane, then what it is called as? It's called as methyl. And what is the formula? CH3. Similarly, ethane, C2H6. If one H is being removed, it's called as ethyl. The formula is C2H5, and one of the bond is shown vacant over here. Whereas here, no such bond is being shown because all the valencies of carbon is being fulfilled. But in this case, one of the valencies is not fulfilled, so that's why this bond is being shown. Propane, propyl, butane, butyl, pentane, pentyl, hexane, hexyl, heptane, heptyl, octane, octyl, nonane, nonyl, decane, decyl. So the only difference is that it's having one hydrogen less, and because it is having one hydrogen less, so it has one bond vacant which is ready to combine with any of the hydrocarbon. steps of formula or writing hydrocarbons. Molecular formula, the actual number of each type of atom present in the compound. So when we write a molecular formula, you need to write the number of atom present in that compound. Like if you write methane, you need to write how many carbon in CH4. So that's giving you information that carbon is 1 and hydrogen is 4. Similarly, structural formula means you need to actually arrange the atoms in writing. You need to mention the structure. So molecular formula and structural formula, you need to know what is a molecular formula and structural formula, and according to that you need to answer it. So here you can see that if methane is being asked, so you need to write the name. This is the molecular formula and this is the structural formula. So name, molecular formula, structural formula. Be particular about that. Similarly, name, its molecular formula, its structural formula. Name, its molecular formula, its structural formula. So you need to remember molecular and structural formula of all the hydrocarbons that are taught in this chapter. Organic chemistry is the child of medicine, and however far it may go on its way with its most important achievements, it always returns to its parent. So organic chemistry is the child of medicine. तो ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री जो है वो इट इज़ अ ब्रांच ऑफ मेडिसिन. सो व्हेन वी स्टडी अबाउट मेडिसिन, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. एंड वेदर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री में अचीव सो मेनी हाइट्स, बट स्टिल इट ऑलवेज हैव टू लुक टूवर्ड्स द मेन ब्रांच